done? We have just contributed to that antibiotic use that's creating all the superbugs that we're not going to be able to handle anyway. Just say, okay. Diseases could be a reason. This is when, remember that differential white blood cell count that I mentioned earlier in the chapter? Where if you get sick, go to the doctor, give you medicine, you don't get better, you go back. They then need to do that differential white blood cell count. Remember me talking about it? That's what this is. Okay? That's where they're going to take the blood, and then they're going to look at that white cell count. All right? They're going to determine which one is out of order. And from there, move forward to try to help fight whatever's invading you. Leukemia. The leuke comes from somewhere, meaning those white blood cells. It's a cancer of the hematopoietic tissue. Usually, you have a very high white blood cell count. When it's myeloid, myeloid is our granulocyte. The eosinophils, basophils, neutrophils. All right, so myeloid. If it's lymphoid, these are our monocytes and lymphocytes. If it's acute, meaning came on quickly, chances are it's going to progress very quickly and death is quick. People can be dead within days to weeks to just a few months if it's acute. If it is chronic, usually you tend to have other symptoms. Takes them a while to diagnose the cancer. Sometimes they can treat it, put it into remission. Survival rates vary with the chronic. Okay? Now, this means the normal cell count is wrong. Whichever one is showing up, those are the cells that are going to be out of control and their numbers. This affects other things about the blood, such as clotting, and you're open to other types of infections. And with the leukemias, that's usually one of the things that is so deadly about the leukemia. Other infections come in, and you can die from the other infections because your body doesn't have the ability to fight it. This is the difference between what should be a normal blood count under the scope versus leukemia. What do you notice about the leukemia blood? Huh? Well, we see a lot more, you're looking at that nucleus, which means that's a white blood cell. Because the red blood cells don't have that. So this is the white blood cell count. But do you notice anything different about the red blood cell portion to the top? Not necessarily clumping, bursting, which is something that is so deadly with the leukemia.
So hemopoietic means red blood cells, right?
Hemopoietic means that pluripotent stem cell.
That's the original cell that can branch off to the white.
That's the original cell that can branch into the red and the white.
So leukemia is cancer of the white blood cells, right?
It's going to be this over most of the time. overproduction of the white blood cell count.
Mm-hmm.
That's still poetic because we've got hemopoietic and
I'm confused.
No, that's okay, but with the one big cell, all right, is that pluripotent stem cell.
Okay, and that's called hemopoietic.
This is, well, hemo would be red.
Yeah.
Leukopoietic. Uh-huh. Okay. But whenever we're talking about the tissue itself, okay, poietic.
Got it. Okay. All right. Thank you.
When they were doing the bone marrow transplant, was that just an attempt to make sure that sometimes the production of one type, does that make sure that they receive or they're producing all of them?
When they do the bone marrow transplant, all right, what they have to do is the person that's going to be the recipient, the goal is to irradiate every white blood cell they have, okay? And then transplant the bone marrow into, in other words, destroy every cell. Transplant the good into them and hope with that genetic information takes over for proper production of the white of the blood cells.
They try to get all of the.
I'm sorry. What?
They try and get all of the.
Yes, they try to get. Yes. Because when the person who is the recipient of the bone marrow, one of the things that becomes so deadly for them, because they irradiate every bit of the tissue. Okay. They are in isolation for, I don't know how long, to tell you the truth. And they're in isolation where, you know, anybody comes in there with them, they're in like the head-to-toe covering, okay? I mean, something as deadly as the person in the covering and their fingernail pokes through the gloves or whatever to kill them. Because of the germs that would come off of the tip of the finger.
That's why it's so deadly in children's everywhere.
We all have bone marrow everywhere. But for children, it's more active. And children, all bone marrow is red marrow, giving rise to the cell. In adults, it's only in certain areas of the body.
Is that like more commonly in children? Just more, it's all red from there.
Childhood leukemias are the more common, but it doesn't mean that adults don't get it either. The problem is, as an adult, if you get leukemia as an adult, chances are it's going to be the acute, and you're going to be dead within days to weeks or a few months. There's usually no treatment. They'll treat you, but all you do is just prolong your death. So, when they do something called a CBC, the complete blood count, this is where they're going to test your hematocrit, your hemoglobin concentration, a total count for your red blood cells, mature, reticulocytes, immature red blood cells, white blood cells, and one that we haven't talked about yet, your platelets. Okay, they can do the differential white blood cell count, and they can get red blood cell size and hemoglobin concentration per red blood cell. This is stuff they can look at when they do a CBC. Each one can be the can be clinically significant, each one. So the next one we've got to talk about, platelets. They're so cute. All right. They are not a cell. They are a fragment. Okay? Now, their job, help control bleeding. Huh, what? Not simply blood moving in our vessels. Okay, but at the time of a breach, help stop the bleeding. That is what is termed hemostasis. Help stop something that could be potentially fatal. Now, granted, we tend to think of the hemorrhage as when we have cut the artery. Yes? Candy?
Hemorrhaging is just massive bleeding, regardless of where it's coming from. Typically, it is an artery.
Thank you. Now, we have blood vessels. Arteries and veins. We haven't talked about it. A major difference. The arteries are under pressure. Veins are not. But you can still have a bleed out from veins. Now, arteries. When we think about something like that, one that might be major, think about the femoral, for example, okay? Under pressure, that means the blood is moving quickly. And every time the heart beats, there is a pulse of blood. Because it's under pressure. So these do tend to be the ones that will get excessive bleeding. But you have arteries, even as small, which can create a problem, and like the tips of your fingers. Okay? A little bit easier, but it will excessively bleed. Okay? A little bit easier to stop. Other ones that are in the larger parts, the larger arteries, we do need to stop that bleeding. Because number one, the heart cannot compensate for it, okay? Blood loss means we're losing blood to other areas of the body. So platelets become important for the control of bleeding. There are three mechanisms that are used to try to stop bleeding. These three mechanisms, a vascular spasm, note they're just telling you a vessel. They're not signifying which one. They're just telling you a vascular spasm. Then we need those platelets to make a plug. And then, if needed, we need blood clotting.
Can you say that like in sequence? Okay.
Yep, these are the three steps. The first one, to the second one, to the third one. Platelets are involved in all three. They are small fragments of what's termed a megakaryocyte. Mega meaning big, cyte meaning cell, karyo meaning nucleus. So they come to us from a big nucleus cell. That big cell is about 2 to 4 micrometers. I know, right? Still sounds small. And it has granules. Where have we heard of that term?